The president of Russia uses a Putin speak in his speeches that we must parse word for word, in our own best interests. Only after translating them into normal speech do we learn what he has said and why. His speech Monday to the United Nations General Assembly made 7 overlapping and interdependent points that are worth translating. Unlike Barack Obama's passionate address, Putin delivered his remarks in the measured and moderate tones of a world statesman. They were still words of warning: join us in a broad coalition and leave non-democratic regimes alone, or catastrophe will strike. Following are the major points that Putin wished his audience to take back to their respective countries. First, the United States and its Western allies are responsible for the sad state of world affairs owing to their foolhardy interventions on behalf of democratic revolutions. Democratic revolutions are the dreams of those who have unrealistic views of the world. The USSR learned that it could not export socialist revolution. The West must learn that it cannot export democratic revolution. Second, the United Nations, not some agglomeration of prosperous Western powers, should guarantee peace and security for all, not just to a select few singled out for narrow benefit. Only the UN can form a broad coalition that can put an end to the terrorist threats of ISIL. The matter is urgent. If such a coalition is not formed soon, the migrant flow to Europe will reach into the millions, not tens of thousands, and no country will be safe from terrorist attack, says Putin. 3. Russia's status as a veto-wielding member of the UN Security Council is not affected by Russia's recent disagreements, namely, the United Nations' condemnation of the Crimean annexation and Russia's veto of a criminal tribunal to punish those responsible for shooting down Malaysia Airlines MH17. Such disagreements, even among the major Western powers, have disrupted the work of the Security Council since the UN's founding. Putin tells his audience that the fact that Russia disagrees with certain UN resolutions is normal and does not affect its veto power. Fourth, the West must understand that the choice between governmentalism, gojudestvenost, and chaos must be made in favor of the former. The Assad government may not be ideal, but it is the only institution of statehood that exists. Libya's Gaddafi regime was tyrannical, but what came afterward had been worse. Well-intentioned actions that destroy a nation's governmentalism leave vacuums that forces of evil, such as ISIL, fill. The ranks of ISIL, for example, were populated with the disaffected remnants of Saddam Hussein's regime. No such thing as a moderate opposition exists, as shown by America's comedic efforts to train and arm anti-Assad forces. Fifth, the West must suppress its appetite for supporting democratic opposition forces that challenge governmentalism in regimes whose human rights, press freedom, and election procedures fall short of Western ideals. Not stated by Putin is that he includes Russia in this category. Hands off Russia's internal affairs. The West's meddling in Ukraine had the unanticipated consequence of what Putin calls a spontaneous civil war, with over 8,000 deaths.